Hello everyone, this video is in continuation to our videos where we were making videos for human reproduction. We have discussed male reproductive system, and in female reproductive system we have discussed the whole reproductive tract. In this video we'll focus on the structure of ovary and various changes which are taking place in the ovary in the females. Okay, watch the video till the end, because at the end all the diagrams and the terminology will be there on the board. You can write them and use them for your notes. Okay, starting up with the structure of ovary, we have already done that there is a pair of ovaries which are abdominal and are present inside the body of the female, as which is different from that of males where the testes are present outside the body, but here it is abdominal. And if we see the structure of the ovary, it has, I'll not say layers, but yes, it has an outer layer here, an outer layer known as tunica albuginea. It's called tunica albuginea, and inside it has a mass fibrous ear structure. It's not a layer, but yes, the cortex region of the ovary. It's called the cortex region of the ovary, which is made up of reticulate connective tissues. This is the cortex part of the ovary, made up of reticulate connective tissues. Okay, then inside the part where all the follicles and the stages are arranged, that part is the internal part known as medulla. I'll label it here. We need some space for the labeling. Known as medulla, which is medulla is made up of areolar connective tissues. Areolar connective tissues. Okay, so these are the three main layers of the, or three main parts of the ovary, and inside here we have the follicles arranged in different stages. Now if you see a section of ovary, you will observe the follicles present at different stages, because it's an ongoing process. Every month a new follicle is formed, graafian follicle is formed and egg is released. So in all the stages will be visible to you in the ovary. So we'll make only one for your clear reference. Here we have the primary follicles, a cluster of primary follicles. Now I'll label it here, primary follicles. Now every month one egg has to mature, so one of these primary follicles will start increasing in size, or you can say start growing bigger or start maturing, the term you want to use, and the follicles which are surrounding will become small. We'll get this kind of a structure. This developing structure inside, the one which is present inside, the one which is developing, will now be called as secondary oocyte. Okay, the follicles, out of the cluster of follicles, one follicle will start maturing and growing in size, will form the secondary oocyte, and the others will be arranged around it. After this we have this secondary oocyte again growing in size, and it has these follicles present around it, which will shrink in size or become small in size, and there is a cluster of other follicles as well which will form a thick layer around it like this. Okay, This is the next stage which we get. After this, we have it reaches. Now this oocyte is going to, you know, reach a stage which we call as Graafian follicle, the most important stage, which we'll draw separately as well. That Graafian follicle stage is the stage where the oocyte remains in that follicle for a while and it grows in size and matures. So if we say this, now I'll make the Graafian follicle here. So here the oocyte remains here. I'll not label the parts of Graafian follicle here. We'll make it separately and then I'd label. And we have these follicles which I told you, which we have already made. The structure remains the same, jo pichla wala hai. A cluster of follicles here. And this whole structure is present in a fluid-filled cavity which is known as antrum, and this fluid filled cavity is also surrounded by a double layered follicular structure. I'll not say double layer, but yes, it's also a layer of follicles and are arranged doubly, matlab it's internal and internal. I'll label, it will be clear there when I label the Graafian follicle separately. And this oocyte, it does not float inside the surface, inside this follicle. It is attached with the surface with the help of a cluster of cells. Now this structure which we get here is known as Graafian follicle. Now this Graafian follicle, it has been given the name Graafian follicle on the name of the scientist Graafian who discovered this process. Okay, now we'll make this Graafian follicle separately and label it. That's for labeling basically. Now we have the secondary oocyte here. This secondary oocyte, as already told, is surrounded by a layer of follicles. This is known as discus proligerus. I'll just label the parts as well. So we'll make it first and then I'll label and give you the functions as well. And it is surrounded by a fluid filled cavity here. We'll make the follicles. Okay. Yeah, I'll just make a coil structure quickly. Okay. It's a double layered, so I'll just make another one. Okay. Fine. Here, this secondary oocyte is not floating. It has an attachment. Okay. It has this attachment, a cluster of cells. Now, we label it and understand. This structure is the secondary oocyte. Then we have this disc-like structure known as discus proligerus. We have this fluid filled. We have this fluid. It has a, it's a viscous fluid which is filled here in this cavity in the Graafian follicle. This fluid filled cavity is known as antrum. I'll just mention it here that it is a viscous fluid filled cavity, and this viscous fluid which is filled inside is known as liquor folliculi. Liquor folliculi or culi, whatever. So this fluid which is filled here is known as liquor folliculi. And we have this attachment, a cluster of cells which attaches this oocyte to the disc around. That's known as germ hill. And the surrounding part, this layer, if we say, if we collectively call this layer, we'll collectively call it membrana granulosa. Membrana granulosa. And agar membrana granulosa, if we divide it, so it's divided into outer, as I made two layers, this is known as tunica externa, the outer one, and tunica interna, the inner one. Okay, so this is the whole structure of a graafian follicle, where we have the secondary oocyte at the center, surrounded by a structure known as discus prolegeris. It is surrounded by a fluid filled cavity, a viscous fluid filled cavity. This fluid is known as liquor folliculi, and this cavity is known as antrum. Surrounding it is the membranous granulosa, which is further divided into tunica externa and tunica in externa and interna. They are layers of follicles. Okay, so they are this whole structure is the graafian follicle. Now, after this, after graafian follicle is formed, the next process takes place, which is the most important process here, known as ovulation. The process which occurs here is ovulation. If I ask you what is ovulation, ovulation is the release of egg from the ovary or from the graafian follicle. That's known as ovulation. Now, what will happen? This graafian follicle is now going to rupture, and this is the leftover mass, whatever will be left. And this oocyte, secondary oocyte, will be released out. Okay, the secondary oocyte will be released out, and the leftover mass is there of the graafian follicle. Now, when this rupturing takes place, there is a blood loss and many blood vessels, they rupture. So this structure, the first structure which is formed when the rupturing of graafian follicle takes place, this first structure is known as corpus hemorrhagica. Corpus hemorrhagica. And the released structure is the, generally we say releasing of egg, but the part which is released is the secondary oocyte. Okay, then this corpus hemorrhagica will now, I have told you that the rupturing of blood vessels take place, there is loss. Now that those blood vessels, they'll heal, they'll be clotting. So that structure which is formed after that clotting is called corpus luteum, a very important structure in the ovary. I'll just extend this wall, because we have a few diagram more to draw. So this structure, which is now formed of corpus hemorrhagica after healing or clotting, is known as corpus luteum. Now, corpus luteum acts as an endocrine gland, releasing the hormone progesterone. And this corpus luteum persists in the body of the female if fertilization occurs. But if there is no fertilization, corpus luteum will degenerate, will shrink and degenerate to form a structure which is known as corpus albicans. This is corpus albicans. Okay, now we have seen that graafian follicle, when it ruptures, when the process of ovulation takes place, three phases of this ruptured graafian follicle are there: corpus hemorrhagica, corpus luteum, and corpus albicans. Corpus hemorrhagica is the first stage. Now this sequence is very important from your paper point of view. It's a one marker asked in various competitive exams also. So first of all, the graafian follicle, it releases the egg in the process of ovulation. The leftover mass is known as corpus hemorrhagica. It has a lot of blood, it has a blood loss here and damaged blood vessels. Those get healed and clotted to form corpus luteum, which acts as an endocrine gland to secrete the hormone progesterone. Corpus luteum will persist in the ovary if there is fertilization already taken place, and then the further changes take place, which we'll be discussing in our next videos. But if there is no fertilization, it shrinks away to form corpus albicans. Please learn the sequence, learn these terms in a sequence. So this is it about the structure of the ovary. We have done the various layers of the ovary. We have done that primary follicles develop to form secondary oocyte and the detailed structure of Graafian follicle, which is a very important question. And then we have done the various stages of corpus luteum, that is hemorrhagica, luteum and albicans. In our next video, we'll be discussing about the external genita, we'll be talking about vulva, and we'll be talking about the various other glands related to female reproductive system. So keep watching, liking, sharing, subscribing. Thank you.